my name is Guy Wallace, and in this PAC video short, we're going to discuss EPI Stage 2. PAC is an acronym. It stands for Performance-Based, Accelerated, Customer and Stakeholder-Driven Training and Development of Any Blend. EPI is also an acronym. It stands for Enterprise Process Performance Improvement. A Stage 1 effort targeting EPI targets the interventions that are going to be necessary to get from the current state to the future state. The current state may be raft with problems that need to be addressed, or everything is just fine and we need to do improvements and make things even better. As always, it depends. But to get from the current state to the future state, we're going to need to change our processes. We're going to need to change the human enablers that will enable those future processes. We're going to need to change the environmental assets that enable those processes. In Stage 2, we're bringing all of that to life. We're putting all of those things in place. We're doing the improvement interventions necessary. Planning in Stage 1 in the fourth phase overlaps mightily with the first phase of EPI Stage 2. EPI Stage 2 is about intervention initiatives. There's an initial project planning and kickoff that overlaps with Stage 1's efforts. Then there's analysis to get down to the fine nitty-gritty details about what needs to be put in place if we're to do these various intervention initiatives. We must design them to make sure that they're compatible, that they'll all go together and work together in unison. We don't want to optimize one thing and sub-optimize the other thing, so we need to take a systems view as we're doing this. We need to then develop and or acquire these interventions, and then we need to pilot test them as a system. Whatever we learn from the pilot test will be then used to revise these interventions and then release them. And perhaps we'll have to pilot test them again and do that two phases over and over again until we get it right enough. It may be necessary to add additional talent when we get to phase 4, develop and acquire these interventions. So we may be expanding our team efforts at this particular point. Six Sigma uses the DMAIC methodology. We may be defaulting to an approach like this when we get to Stage 2. As always, it depends. Whereas EPI Stage 2 can look very streamlined and simple, your set of interventions that you may need to project manage and conduct might be much more complex. You might have several work streams, work stream A, B, and C. As you do your macro project planning on the front end, that'll lead to doing analysis of A, B, and C to specify all the specific requirements, and then do designs to meet all of those specific requirements. But then you'll may need to do an integration test of the design itself to see, is this really going to work? So you need to do some integration testing of the designs as A, B, C, and not simply as A and B and C, but together. And then you'll need to develop A and B and C, and perhaps you need to develop two of those and buy the third one, whatever. But then once you have them developed, you can do an integration test. So the pilot test is a real live test, as authentically as you can make it. The development test may be more of a bench test where you theoretically look at this, where you test it out back at the shop before you take it out to the field. The pilot test is out there in the field, out there in the real world, whatever that intervention is, where you're trying to actually see, can this be broken? In fact, what you're trying to do is break it in the pilot test so that you can fix it permanently before you do a general release and foist this on your world. So if you do an integrated pilot test, that would lead to any revisions and then a release of A, B, and C. A might be a new IT system and tools. B might be a new set of policies and procedures. C might be training of all the humans that are involved. And what you wanted to see was, is all this work as a system to affect performance to affect processes positively. I've been practicing, publishing, and presenting on these methods since 1982. My recent book, Six Pack, covers all of this in great detail.